Hi, Sharks. So it's been quite a while since I've done a painting, and I thought today I'd just do something quick and simple. I've been wanting to paint. I haven't been feeling well. That's why you haven't seen or heard from me. I apologize. I did try to load a video, though, last week. It's so strange. I did a video on, let's see. I did a video on some poppies. I think I put them in here. Yeah, these poppies. I tried to load the painting multiple times, and for some reason, it kept getting pixelated. And I apologize for that. It was just a quick video. It was like a 2.5 minute video. This was just a fun little painting I did, and I really wanted to share it all with you guys. I'll do another one sometime, but I apologize that it came out so pixelated. But today, I think I'm going to do a little butterfly painting in watercolor. And so let's get started. And hopefully, this video will not be pixelated like the other one. You know, I use my phone for my video recording, and most of you already know that. But the one thing that has changed since I did that video, or before I did that video, was I had to do an update on my phone because I have the S7 Edge. I was forced to get that when the Note grenade was taken off the market, and I loved that phone. It never overheated once, but this one overheats several times a day, doesn't hold a charge. It's just awful. But anyway, it's still got a good camera. And they just came out with the Samsung S8 and S8 Edge, I believe. So, not the Note yet. I'm waiting on that. And when that comes out, I can go ahead and transfer my phone back to that. But so the only thing I can figure out is that something changed in their camera settings. They had this problem back in 2016 before I bought my phone. So I don't know if that's the issue. So anyway, let's get started and keep our fingers crossed that we do not have any issues with pixelation. So after I drew the butterfly in, all I did was wet the background and just did a wet into wet and added a little bit of yellow and pink, and then I went back and added a little bit of blue after it was dry, so it gave it kind of this blooming effect, which is what I was going for. Now I'm going to go ahead and I should have taped that down because it started to roll up. I'm just using, I don't know what paper I'm using. It was something that came in one of the Doodle and Sketch boxes, I believe. Thought it was 100% cotton, but this might just be some Fabriano studio paper. So let's go ahead and paint the butterfly. What I think I'm going to do here is I'm going to go ahead and get a little bit of cobalt blue. I did not wet my paints down, and I should have. Get them going a little bit. There we go. That'll get them moving. I'm just going to put some cobalt blue in a on my palette, and just I don't want it too bright. So I'm going to go ahead and put this on the butterfly here. And then while this is wet, I'm going to go down here. I'm going to paint this whole thing in with the blue. But then I'm going to go back and I'm going to add some pink to it. A little bit of pink. It's just very, very strong. I got to get it watered down too. Then I'm just going to go back in here and kind of bleed it in. This is not a real butterfly. It's just something I'm thinking up in my head as I go. So that's all that is. Oops, something I did forget to do though. I don't want those pens. So I forgot to put the lines in the bottom here. I need to go like this. That'll work. Okay. And we'll keep on going here at the bottom. I'm going to take some blue again. Try to go around these circles as much as I can. Diesel. The dog is getting antsy. It's a beautiful day outside. Oh my gosh, you guys won't believe what happened. This morning, I was in my hot tub. I wasn't feeling well, so I thought I'd get in the hot tub for a while and just soak. And I was in there, and Pat came home from church. He went grocery shopping, and then after church and came home, and he was unloading groceries. And then he comes outside all upset. Where's Diesel? And I'm like, in the house, I think. And he's like, no, he's not in the house. And I thought, okay, well, don't get mad at me. I didn't let him out, you know. Here, let me dry this real quick. And so I said, okay, well, let me get dressed and I'll start looking for him. So I thought I'll put the top down on my car and I'll just drive around the neighborhood and call him. I was calling him and calling him. He has never run away. In the 8 years that we have had him, he sticks by our side. He hardly leaves the yard. He'll go to the neighbor's yard where they feed him dog biscuits, but that's about it, you know? So Pat comes in. He had been unloading the groceries, so he said, well, I have to move my car to let you out. And I said, okay. So I finished getting the top down and all that, and I got into my car, and I'm just getting ready to back up, and Pat had opened his door, and out pops the dog. He had unloaded the groceries and has the electric closure on the hatch of his car, and Diesel had somehow jumped in the back hatch. And so when he opened his door, out popped Diesel. And all I could think was, thank goodness it's April here, because if it was July and he had been stuck in there, he could have been a cooked puppy. And I wouldn't want that. So anyway, yeah, all's well that ends well. It was kind of funny. Out he pops. Pat's all mad and angry, and I'm thinking, okay, well, you're the one who locked him in the car, dude. That was funny. Well, it wasn't funny at the time, but looking back on it now, it's pretty funny. So, anyhow, I was happy that he was okay, you know. Now I'm going to go ahead and grab some sap. And I want it a little bit darker, so I'm going to add some of that cobalt blue that I had been using in that. And I'm just going to bring this up. I'm making a stem here. My butterfly is on a butterfly bush, or some sort of bush. And he hopped on for lunch. Okay, now I'm going to make a stem that goes along the side, and it's just going to, one of them's going to pop right off the top like this. This stem is going to end up a little hidden, but, and now I'm going to mix up some purples. Actually, I've got some purples that are in my palette I can use, like some cobalt teal or cobalt violet, which is pretty good light fastness, and a cobalt violet pale that I can use. I'm going to start with that, and basically all I'm going to do is start at the tip, and then I'm just going to dot in some of these colors all along. Nice light pale lavender. gradually we're going to go darker. So it's going to have a few different colors on it. But I want this one first. It's going to dry underneath, and you'll just see a little bit of it underneath. So that's why I'm kind of smearing it a little bit. Okay, now I'm going to go in with a little bit darker color, my cobalt teal, or cobalt, gosh, I keep saying that, my cobalt violet. This was cobalt violet pale. And now I'm going in with cobalt violet, and some of it's going to mix together. The tip, I want more of that cobalt violet pale to show, though. These are Daniel Smith colors, if you're wondering. Just a simple little painting, something to do real quick on a Sunday afternoon. You know what I've been getting into lately? I've been working on my lettering. Since I wasn't feeling good, I thought, okay, I'll sit down. And I got these two books at Office Max. Let me show them to you. I'm pretty happy with them. This is one of them. Really nice. Clearance, $4. Lined paper so that I can practice my lettering. And then I got another one that's flowered, which I don't really care for. I usually don't go for, but I got it just for something different. And then they had another geometric one that was more manly. But two of them, $8. So I got those, and I've been working on my lettering a little bit. And I decided, because I have such bad brain fog, that I'm going to go ahead and start bullet journaling. I was like, no way, I don't need to do that. I use my phone for pretty much everything, you know. All my important appointments, I set alarms so that I get out of bed. I don't forget to go to the doctor or anything like that, because I will forget. Ah, shoot. I will forget everything. Flinging my brush all over the place here. So now I'm adding a little bit of my magenta into my cobalt violet to make a more of a reddish purple, and that's going to go on top. It's not wet enough though. Let me get it wetter. There we go. So I decided to start bullet journaling, and I got a journal at Office Max, and I came home. Of course, then that did me in, and I couldn't do anything the rest of the day because I walked in the store. So it's so aggravating. My hips just hurt so bad. I can't stand it. I was up all night, too. Then I missed church this morning. I couldn't even go. But anyway, I got this journal, and I started to set it up. And first, I didn't like the way I set it up. So I decided, no, that's not going to work. And the other problem I was having with it was that it... the pages are too thin, and every time I wrote on it with ink, it would come right through the other side. And I'm talking like either a permanent, a mark, you know, like one of these, or just my fountain pen, you know, like my platinum carbon. Everything was just popping through. I thought, this is ridiculous. So that didn't work. So I decided to use it for practice and setting up my journal and how I want it to be, because you set up these bullet journals yourself if you don't know anything about them. I've been watching somebody called Boho Berry, B-O-H-O-B-E-R-R-Y, two words, Boho Berry, and she has some really cool ideas. She also has an Etsy shop. You can buy her stickers and mandala stickers and stuff for the outside. I think I might paint mine. I got one of those, what's it called? Oh, shoot. I don't know how to pronounce it. It's called Leuchtturm. Leucht-Turm, the 1917 notebook. It's an A5 hardcover. It's got 249 pages dotted, dotted graph. And the one that I had was a graph, and I was setting it up. And I'm sorry, I'm getting off base a little bit here, but I got to let that dry anyway. So I was setting it up, and I thought, okay, well, I'll show you what I did so far for April, if I can find it. That's how I set it up. But I've got a lot of stuff to put in here, and this is just April. But I don't like the extra graph showing. I want the dotted graph paper. And there's, you know, other lists like my travel list and stuff like that that I put in here and things like that. So anyway, I'm using this for practice and how I want to set up my journal, and then my journal will come in a couple days and I can redo the whole thing. It's good practice. But I'm also working on that lettering. And Wine Lover 215 got me involved in the challenge. I'm using the Cobalt Violet Pale again. This is what it looks like. And then that's Cobalt Violet. And then my magenta, Quinacridone Magenta, is the final thing I use. And I mix it in with the other one. But anyway, Wine Lover 215 got me involved, Tom, got me involved in, from Instagram, in the Rock Your Handwriting Challenge. I know, I think Cheryl Wright's doing it also. A couple other viewers that I follow and follow me on Instagram. If you're on Instagram, hit me up, follow me, and I will follow you back. That way we can share our artwork with each other, which would be fun. And our writing progress and bullet journaling progress and anything else that you're into. I'd love to see it all. I know I was talking to Essie Tangle, who also does ceramics. And I was very interested in what she had to say. I told her, I said, I want to see it. Do you have a shop or an Instagram or something? And she doesn't. So I said, well, come on, you guys got to get out there. Put your stuff out there so we can see it. I'd love to see what you guys do. I mean, I am so impressed by some of the work that I've been seeing, all of the work that I've been seeing. Eve Bolt, Cheryl Wright, Wine Lover 215. There's a bunch of you out there that I follow. So, I'm sorry, there goes the dog. It's spring and he just can't help himself. okay, so now I'm going to go in with the next darker color and just kind of dot it here and there. This one I want to look a little different than the other one, so I'm going to leave it a little bit pinker, I think. So anyway, when my bullet journal comes, I'm going to start doing that. I think it'll help to keep me a little more organized. And I can set my budget, can't spend on any art supplies or anything. So it's kind of a bummer right now, really a bummer. So this is pretty easy, this painting. Hopefully you guys are doing it along with me. And I hope that there's no pixelation in the video, because it sure would be nice to get it up there for you guys. If I can fix the other one, I'll post that one too. There's a couple of things that I can try. I just haven't felt good enough to try them. So, okay, now I'm putting in the final color that has the Quinacridone Magenta mixed in with the Cobalt Violet to make it more of a red purple. And I am just getting that down here. These dots kind of grow and swell into each other, which is kind of nice. If you keep doing it while it's wet, then they'll kind of blend together, which is kind of fun. And that is pretty much the extent of it. Let me get it dried, and then I will show you the Oh, wait, there's one more thing I want to do. I want to take a little deeper blue. I want to go along the edges of this. There's usually some sort of a line that comes down. These swallowtails have long, long little pokey things at the end. That's how you can tell the difference if you're not familiar, real familiar with butterflies. You see an orange and black butterfly and you think, oh, it's a monarch. I haven't seen one in so long. If it has the long thing at the bottom of the tail, it is not a monarch. They look like monarchs, but they are not. Those are called swallowtails. I'm a big butterfly fanatic, so I have a butterfly book and everything. I take it on vacation with me so I can identify them and all sorts of stuff. But okay, and that's it. So everybody have a terrific afternoon. Be courageous, paint with wild abandon, and most of all, be kind to each other. And if you're interested in bullet journaling or lettering or any of that stuff, maybe we can work on that together. So let me know if you're interested. And as I get better at it and get into it, then I will share some of my progress as well. So have a great day, everybody. And if you have any questions for You Asked For It, please send them my way. I have not received any questions of late, so they can be about anything, art-related or Sharon-related. So if you have questions, just put them in the comments below down in the basement, and I will respond to you. So thanks a lot, everybody. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.